Did your company lend money to an individual just to help them out? Well, you should know that recording lending money to a friend should be recorded differently in your QuickBooks records than the money that is owed to you from regular customers. And whether you're using QuickBooks Online for your personal home finances or using QuickBooks Online for a small business, this video is going to show you exactly how to record that. Now, we all know someone in our lives that continuously comes to people with their hand out, whether it be a distant cousin, whether it be a long-lost friend, or just someone you know in your circle. So let's have our example person whom we are lending money to be one of our favorite cousins, Danny Deadbeat. Danny Deadbeat is kind enough to borrow money from you so that the audience at home can clearly see how to record lending money to a friend as part of your home family finances. So in a way, he's helping you.
So, Danny comes to you and he says that he has a temporary, one-time emergency that is totally not his fault, but he needs you to give him some of your money right now.
Huh?
So, you need an account in the chart of accounts to keep track of what he owes as he's making the payments. If he makes the payments.
So before we record the transaction, we will put an account in the chart of accounts that will be an asset type of account that will record the original loan to Danny and also record any payment that he paid back so we can track the balance as it's being paid back. Now, you should know a couple of things about this account. First of all, it's an asset, but when you lend money to a friend, it's proper to put the detail type as current asset. We hope this will be a current asset, if you know what I mean. Secondly, we have to decide a name. And the name that we give should not confuse it with any money that we actually borrowed from someone else. So let's call this account Receivable from Danny. We hope it's receivable, but that name will clarify the difference between money that's owed to us and any money that we might owe in future chapters. And again, we can open the chart of accounts by either clicking the cogwheel and going over to where it says chart of accounts, or in the left panel, click transactions, chart of accounts. Now, once we're in the chart of accounts, we remember you go to the top right and click new. Now, the name, again, will be Receivable from Danny. So as to not confuse it with money that we owe to other people. So don't put the word loan in the name. Now, of course, the account type is other current asset, we hope, and the detail type in this case would not affect us, but let's choose a proper one anyway, other current asset. Now we click save, and now we're able to record lending money to this individual. So if Serena wrote check number 12 for $500 on April 28th to Danny Deadbeat, what will be the result in the trial balance? Well, no need for fancy animation at this point. We know that the cash in the bank account will decrease by $500. And the current asset account called Receivable from Danny will show up in the trial balance for the first time as $500. Let's take a look. So, of course, this check came from the bank account. So we click the cog wheel and we go to chart of accounts. And we go down to the Chase bank account. If you have trouble finding it, then remember, you click created by you, and we only see the accounts that we created, so it's easier to find the Chase bank account. Click view register. And of course, this is adding a check, and the date is April 28th. Of course, in our little story, 2026, the computer remembers we're up to check number 12 if we choose transaction type check, and the payee is not yet on the list, but we can add his name on the list as you can put him as a vendor, a customer, or an employee. So since we're lending the money, it really doesn't matter, but we'll put him as a customer and we'll call him his name. As long as the name is on the list, it doesn't really matter which of the three categories. They will all show up as an option in the payee field. So we put the name Danny Deadbeat that we add on the fly as we're doing the transaction. Click Save. And you can always go back to the customer area of data that we learned about at the beginning and add his address, his phone number, his website, email, and so on, or remove him from the list later. But the account category that we put in this case is the new account that we added. Type in REC to abbreviate receivable from Danny. And we gave him $500. Enough to make Serena's mother really mad that she loaned this guy the money. So when we click save, the results in the trial balance are going to be exactly what we discussed. When we click reports and we open our good friend, the trial balance, and we zoom in a bit, you can see that receivable from Danny showed up for the first time as $500, and the Chase bank account, believe it or not, is $500 less than it was a moment ago. And to prove it, I can double click and scroll to the very bottom and see, if it lets me, sure, that April 28th, I wrote a check number 12 to Danny Deadbeat, and that before this check, the balance was $3,230. After the $500 check, it's $2,730 that it showed in the face of the trial balance. So now, let's imagine it's April 28th, and Danny miraculously pays back $100 of the $500 that he took from Serena. Now, imagine he gave physical cash, and Serena does not feel like going all the way to the bank to deposit this cash. So she will still acknowledge that he paid back $100 of the $500, but she will keep this cash in her wallet. So what will be the result in the trial balance when she records this cash repayment of the loan? Well, as I mentioned, she's keeping this cash in the wallet. So Serena's wallet will increase by $100. And of course, because Danny paid back some of the money he borrowed, the account receivable from Danny will decrease by $100 and become $400. Let's take a look. So again, from the left panel, we click Transactions, Chart of Accounts, and because the money is being deposited into Serena's wallet, Serena's wallet register is the one that we will open. We double click, and again, this is a deposit because we are physically depositing Danny's check or Danny's cash to Serena's wallet. So that's why transaction type is deposit. And unless I misspoke, the date that we physically received this money was April 28th of 2026. Now, the person whom we received it from was Danny Deadbeat. But the reason we received it was because of the receivable from Danny, the specific account that we originally set up to track the loan balance of what he owes us. That's the account that goes into the category. Now remember, Serena's wallet is going up. So this is a deposit to Serena's wallet of $100. So make sure you put the money in the deposit field. And when we click save, we can open the trial balance and see the results are exactly as what we expected. Receivable from Danny has decreased to $400 from $500 because now he owes us less because he gave us $100. And you can see Serena's wallet is $100 fatter than it was a moment ago. I can double click the balance of Serena's wallet and look at the very last transaction on the 28th was from Danny Deadbeat. And before he gave her the money, it was $855. And after this $100, she now has $955 in her wallet. Now, at some point, you might want to make a point with this person who keeps borrowing money. So let's imagine Serena says to Danny, I would like your next $100 payment to additionally include an extra $50 of interest. That will help him understand that time is money and everything costs. But if Danny gives you a $150 payment, where $100 is supposed to reduce what he owes, and the other $50 is income you earned by lending the money to him, how would you record that? Well, before you record that, you would have to add an account to the chart of accounts to record just the interest income that you received from Danny as a separate amount that you earn and keep, separate from whatever amount he gives you to pay back the loan and decrease the balance. So let's imagine on April 14th, Danny gave you another $150 in cash. And again, we will still keep it in Serena's wallet, but we have to acknowledge that only $100 is decreasing the balance of the receivable loan to Danny, and the other $50 Serena keeps as a service fee, which is interest because she was kind enough to lend him the money. So we have to go to the chart of accounts and create an account called interest income. And because this is not the normal way Serena earns money, and because this is something that's rare and uncontrollable, we will not put a normal income type of account. We will again put other income, so it does not affect our net income from operations, and we can still make a judgment of how well we're doing without this loan or this interest from Danny ruining the month-by-month comparison of our profit and loss. So let's go ahead and add the account now. And again, we open the chart of accounts. We click transaction, chart of accounts, or the other way, and we're adding a new account. And the name of it is interest income. Okay, now, of course it's income, but we will not put the normal type of income. We will not put this. We will put other income for reasons that I mentioned. And the detail type, again, in this case, doesn't affect anything, but let's do it properly. Other miscellaneous income. And now when we click save, we now have an account in the chart of accounts to record just the interest that we get and keep for ourselves, separate from the amount that Danny pays back as a service fee to Serena for being kind enough or foolish enough to lend the money. So because we need two accounts in addition to Serena's wallet as part of this transaction, it would be better to record it in the deposit window instead of the register window. So from the top left, we click new and we go over to bank deposit. Now, of course, the date is May 2nd of 2026, and the money is being deposited into Serena's wallet from Danny. Now, we have to click this down triangle in order to be able to get this little section here. Now, we received from Danny as part of this transaction interest income that Serena earned as a service fee that she keeps for herself for being kind enough to lend Danny the money. So this $50 on the first line will not decrease the principal of the receivable balance. But on the next line, we should also put Danny's name because he's the one associated with this. And on the next line, we put the receivable account that tracks the balance. And that one is only decreasing by $100. So the entire deposit is $150, but only $100 decreases the receivable, and $50 is Serena's income that she keeps forever as a service fee. So we click Save and Close, and when we click Reports to check the results in the trial balance, you can see the results are exactly as what we expected. You can see that the interest income that Serena earned was $50, and now the new balance of the receivable from Danny is $300. So I zoomed in a tiny bit too much, but you can see if I double-click on that $300, you can see why it's $300, because originally we gave him a check from the Chase bank account for $500, and he gave us two consecutive payments of $100 that went into Serena's wallet. And the additional $50 in the last payment, that's interest expense that she keeps, so it does not decrease the balance of the receivable. And if you enjoyed this little bit of comedy education, you should know that this video is only one video chapter in the full home finance course right here on YouTube, and it's free. So if you want to enjoy learning everything about QuickBooks Online while at the same time mastering all the ideas of personal and home family finances, you can watch the entire free course by looking in this video's description field under the table of contents to the link to the main course. Serena and I would love it if you watched the course and made a little comment in the comment section so that we could help you with anything you need.